question. Ajay, tell me quickly, this kind of graph is possible or not? This is displacement time. Is this possible? Possible? Okay. Now, is this possible? The answer was yes, that was possible. Distance time. This? Distance cannot decrease. Okay, it will always accumulate. So the slope of distance time curve will always be positive. Can you write down? Slope of distance time curve will be always positive. The distance always increases with time. And if suppose this is your displacement time graph, can you convert this displacement time graph into distance time graph? How to do that? Yes, it will be somewhat like this. Okay, the distance will keep on increasing. Again, rate of change of distance will be zero somewhere here. So it will be like that. Because velocity was close to zero, magnitude of speed was zero over here, slope was zero. Okay, so these are the some final things which if I ask you in an isolated manner, you'll be very proactive and you'll be quickly identify, yes, this is not possible. But if I give you a question where this is being utilized, probably one small part of the question, this is where you have to pay attention and identify, yes, this is not possible, this is possible, then you may not be probably able to identify it, or you may not be able to be that active enough to identify it. Okay? That kind of thing will come only when you solve a lot of questions of higher order. Okay, next question, all of you do this. A good strain accelerating uniformly on a straight railway track. Okay, train and jari hai. This is train. Approaches an electric pole standing on the side of the track. So yep, this is a pole. Abhi train is going in a straight line and there's a pole. That's it. Right now, this is the story. Its engine passes a pole with velocity u. Its engine, of course, we are assuming it is in the front. Its velocity is u. Okay? And the guard's room passes with velocity v. Guard is at behind so that he can run away. So what will happen is that this train is going in a straight line. The front part is passing with velocity u and the back portion is passing with velocity v, the pole. Okay, you need to find the speed with which the middle portion of the train will pass the pole. The train is accelerating uniformly. The front portion of the train is passing with velocity u. The back side is passing with velocity v. With what velocity the center of the train will pass? Acceleration is constant. If you would have listened to the question properly, doesn't matter. Uniform acceleration. I think this similar question we did. You remember the root of events that we used to write to something like that? V plus? I think that was correct. I think it is correct. You will be wrong also. क्यों होगा एवरेज वेलोसिटी बाय या फ्रंट पार्ट हैज नो साइड आई डिड नॉट पॉइंट आउट इट बैक पार्ट आल्सो पॉइंट आउट इट बट द लेंथ ऑफ द ट्रेन यू कांट टेक पॉइंट टोटल लेंथ यू कैन से इट इज एक्स सो दिस इज एक्स बाय 2 and that is x by 2. Okay, here is, nobody is able to do it properly. Suppose velocity of the middle part is v1, okay? So, when this, from this pole, let's say the train is accelerating with acceleration A, so I can say that V1 square is equal to U square plus 2A into X by 2. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. And I can also say that this velocity is given as V, the back portion. So I can also say that V square is equal to V1 square plus 2A into X by 2. Okay, so I get the value of A into X from first equation, which is what? V1 square by U square, which is A into X, and substitute it over here. So V square equal to V1 square plus V1 square minus U square. So V1 is equal to V square plus U square by 2. Exactly same as the previous, you remember the first, second question you did? So same question can be asked in 100 different ways. That is why you cannot study class 11th like you could have studied in class 10th, where you try to typify the question, okay, type 1 question, type 2 question, type 3, no. There will be some million type of questions. No, you are assuming the type is not the same. Distance and time is not moving. The first, see, if it is accelerating, first half will be covered later than the second half. Okay, next question. See, when we ask that is 4 hours too long a period, more than half the class said yes, it is long. Now, when I'm giving you option, all of you are staying back, just one of left. Okay, so do not feel pressurized unnecessarily that since others are staying back, so I should also stay back. Okay, I am not pushing you out, by the way. Okay, here is the question. All of you listen. Listen carefully. Probably the last question for today. Okay, probably the last question. So do it properly, get the right answer. How do you? No, I got confused.
Sir, give options.
Okay, shh. Listen here. No options will be given. 2 points. I am reading a question and only once I will read it. Okay? You should have this habit of doing it. I mean, see, if it is not like, you know, somebody will come and explain to you question again and again, and if you have this habit of, you know, first take a lot of time to understand what is going on, ask question about the question itself, then you know what will happen is that in the exam, this is what is your habit, right? It will not change suddenly. You have to develop the habit in which you, at the first time itself, you draw the diagram properly and start solving it. And that will not come suddenly. Okay? So listen to the question and try to get it right the first time. Anyways, in the exam, you should not spend more than 3-4 minutes at max in a question. But we are spending 10 minutes on this single question because probably, you know, we are doing it this type of question for first time. Write down two particles P and Q. Draw the diagram directly, okay? Don't write the stories. Two particles P and Q simultaneously start moving. Simultaneously start moving from point A with velocities 15 meter per second and 20 meter per second respectively. Again, both P and Q starts from point A with 15 meter per second and 20 meter per second. Okay? Right? The two particles move with the acceleration. The two particles move with acceleration equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Anything. It is not given. What is given is accelerations are equal in opposite direction. Okay? But the velocities are in the same direction. Understood? Listen here. When P overtakes Q at point B, P overtakes Q at point B, then its velocity is 30 meter per second. When P overtakes Q at point B, its velocity is 30 meter per second. You need to find out velocity of Q at that moment. Aditya, see, gone away. Gone away, Aditya, see. Your parents are. I don't know the answer. Actually, finance is not in there. But I'll solve it, don't worry. Okay, one of the students got the answer. Five, two of them got the same answer. Five. And yes, five is one of the options. Five.
Yeah,
so that's okay. Okay, I'm solving it now. Guys, focus here. This is point A. Fifteen meter per second and 20 meter per second. 15 is whose velocity? T. And this is Q. The two particles move in the same acceleration, equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. When P overtakes Q at B, let's say over here P overtakes Q, what will happen is that Q will move with more velocity but its acceleration is backwards. Okay, so its velocity will decrease, but P will move forward but it has acceleration forward. So its velocity will increase. Initially Q will run away. But then slowly and slowly it will decrease its velocity and P will increase and then P will overtake and keep P. So this is what is happening. When P overtakes B, its velocity is 30. So P's velocity is 30 over here, 30 meter per second. So if I assume A as acceleration, okay, I can write V is equal to U plus AT. Yes or no? So V is what? 30, U is 15 plus A into T. So A into T will become 15. So I have, although I don't know what is A and I don't know what is T, but I have got A into T. And time for both is same and A is also same for both magnitude wise, right? Now I have to find velocity of Q at B. So I can use V is equal to UT, U plus AT for Q. So V, I don't know, I want to find it. U is 20 minus A into T, right? And A into T is 15. So just substitute there, you will get 5. No Okay, if you have this habit of first finding A, then finding P, and then substituting to get the answer, you will not be able to solve this. Okay? Right? So, a very small portion of the chapter is left, relative velocity. It will take half an hour. Okay? And I will be done with the chapter, but you are not done till you solve. If you are preparing for JEE Mains or KVPY, you are not done with the chapter till you solve minimum 250 to 300 questions from today. Today you can solve around 100 questions. You have how much? This is 5 p.m. right now. 5 p.m. right now. Questions, 100 questions, 4 hours. So right now it is 5 p.m. by the time you go back home, then you eat, sleep, play with friends, becomes 7. 7, after 7 you can spend 3-4 hours, chalo, not 100, you can solve 50 questions minimum. If you are not solving 50 questions, you are not serious for JEE Mains. Okay, that's the thumb rule. Today, if you are able to solve 50, then you have some seriousness towards the cause. Otherwise, you're just saying it. You're not doing it.